Hello there. In this video, we're going to see how to use an Ethernet shield along with your Arduino Uno to talk to the internet. This is really exciting. This is the core of IoT devices that you want to be able to talk to the internet or your network. And this is the foundation of it. So for that, we're going to use a Wiznet 5100 chip. This is a CMOS chip and all the protocols of TCP and UDP are hard-coded into the chip, so it's capable of TCP, UDP, POPI, and all the other popular network communication protocols. The Ethernet shield gets powered by the Arduino Uno itself, and it takes a 3.3 volts. So in the next part of the video, we will see how to construct and how to run some sample codes. So this is our Arduino Uno board. And this is our Ethernet shield. All you gotta do is fit the shield on top of the board. So just be gentle with the pins. You gotta match the pins from the starting. So it's very simple. This has to go inside. So obviously, all the pins are going to line up. So you just slowly and gently apply pressure. So the pins are in contact. And now you have to connect your Ethernet cable. It's very straightforward. Just connect it to your Ethernet shield. There you go, that's it. And obviously the other end goes to your router. So we have connected the boards, and if you see that the lights are glowing, so basically we have, so PWR is obviously part of the board. We have RX and TX, this is receiving and sending, and then we have a link, so that means you're connected to the internet. Make sure that you reset your board once you have connected the Ethernet cable, only then will it come live. Let's take a look at some examples how to use this setup. We're first going to use a program written by Arduino itself. So you go to File, you go to Examples, and in the libraries for Ethernet, you can pull up something called the Web Client. So the Web Client is a program which basically is posting a request to a resource. In this case, it's Google, and it's getting a response back. So we just want to check if things are working. The one thing you will have to change is the IP address here. So for me, it's 192.168.1.9er. I have changed it to 9er. It could be anything. So how to find out is you can open your command prompt. The way to open command prompt is from the start, you just type cmd, enter. You would get command prompt. And once you have the prompt, you can type ipconfig. If it is a Linux machine, you can type ifconfig. So once you type ipconfig, it's going to show all your configurations. So right on the top, it looks like this for me because I have a couple of VMs installed at this point in time. So what you want to see is the IP4 address here. So it says 192.168.1.5. So basically, you're going to keep the first three sets of numbers the same and just change the last digit. So this can be anywhere between 0 to 255. For me, I have chosen it as 9. Just a quick walkthrough to the code. So here is the resource. We are calling a DNS server, and the DNS will get the actual resource IP address. And if you come down, you see the HTTP request we are making, and we are obviously printing all of that to the serial. Let's run this real quick. Right, so the code is being uploaded. As you can see that the lights are glowing, and it should, yep, the RX and TX must be glowing. So let's open the serial. There you go. You see that it's talking and it's getting a response back from Google. All right, perfect. Looks good. Now let's take this one step ahead, right? Let's create a web server. Now again, the code for the web server is also here. You can go to examples,
we can pull up the Ethernet library and go to web server. So the same changes you have to make here is you gotta change the IP address, right? So I'm gonna pull up one which I have. You can all obviously use the same code from the library. So here, these are the two libraries which we are calling, boards and Fermata. So this is the, these are the libraries. And then if you come down, these are the libraries for HPI. And this is for your Ethernet, so to communicate to the internet. Now I have, if you see here, I have made a change, it's 9. So what we're gonna do in this is we are calling, we're basically creating an instance of a server at the port 8081 on this IP, and we are printing the values read from your analog pins. So if you see here, it's reading all your analog pins and it's writing to your web server. And the web server is available at 192. The same IP which we saw earlier, 192.168.1.9er, port is 8081. So it's slightly different. The last one we sent a, we posted a HTTP request. This is creating a server which will host some resources, right? Now let's run this. Okay, so it says that server is at 192.168.1.9. So this is what we're printing to the serial. Now, just open your browser and go to 192.168.1.9. There you go. Now, this is the resource 192.168.1.9-8081. So this, these are all the values which we are getting on this specific URL. And if you go back, and even your serial is printing out messages when it is communicating to the client. Well, with that, you should be able to set up your Ethernet board with your Arduino board, you should be able to connect to the internet, try some basic stuff, and also create an instance of the web server and try to push some values to the web server. So this is the, you know, fundamentals. Once you understand this or are able to use this, then the later whatever experiments and products you want to create, then it'll be very useful